It's time now for Police on the Scene with a Crime Prevention Lean, with your host, police officer and national crime prevention professional, J.D. Dine.
Ladies and gentlemen, hi, I'm Tim Kretschmann. I'm the producer of the hottest show on crime prevention out there, Police on the Scene with the Crime Prevention Lean. And it is my honor to get to introduce our host, J.D. Dine.
Tim, how are you, my friend?
Fantastic. Well, you're in quarantine.
I am. Well, look, I was going to say, you haven't shaved either. I mean, no. It puts at least 10 years on me.
Yeah, well, it's taking some pounds off of me as it's covering the third chin. So that's pretty good for me. And I see, once again, you got a special hat on. You always have a special hat. What's going on?
I do. Friends from MPD. Or MPD, that would be Milwaukee. I actually have that hat, too. But I got this, obviously, from New York PD. I mean, they've been, you know, obviously very busy with, with this COV-19. Just give them a shout-out tonight. I actually have a fire hat later that I had one at my training sessions from a fire department. Maybe I'll put that on, too. And then, of course, right here, we have our Wisconsin Crime Prevention Practitioners Association. They've been a big supporter of us. So
you're looking in Skype. Everything you think is that way is that way.
It's the opposite. And, <I know. laughs> and did you see who's over my, would be my left shoulder?
Yeah.
Now, what is that? Talking police car. Yep.
That's a talking police car.
Yep, and he's actually, he won't talk tonight, but we might fire him up at one time if we have a big scam alert.
Well, that's great, and that'll be a lot of fun for everybody. So why don't you, what we told people we were going to talk about today is there are a couple of scams that are out there based on all the fear that's out there with the coronavirus, but a lot of these sound familiar, don't they, JD?
Yeah, they really do, Tim. And the problem is that it's the same stuff, different topic. And, you know, I don't have to tell you what the topic is right now. It's the virus, you know. I mean, so, you know, take a different topic out. You know, it might have been 9/11, 20 years ago or so, almost 19 years ago. I mean, you know, it could have been like the Boston Marathon when they had that tragedy. I mean, these scammers, they're relentless, and they have zero ethics. They have no conscience. And, you know, they'll take any situation they can and try to put your money in their pocket. And this is another perfect example. And I think the other thing, Tim, is with everybody, you know, being, you know, shelter in place or stay at home or whatever term you want to use, they know people are home. And right. So they're calling up, trying every angle possible. And some of the scams, you know, I've had some friends that have had some are very similar. They're not even related to maybe the virus, but they're getting more, you know, victims because there's more people home.
Is there a common thread? Is there something that if I hear them say this, I should be worried?
The biggest thing is when people start asking you for bank information, social security numbers, your last four, you know, and I say this and some people roll their eyes and they'll say, yeah, if anyone ever asks you to send gift cards, you know, to take care of a bill or a utility, it's definitely not. All the legit companies, Tim, they know your information, and the scammers don't. You know, and they're really good at what they do. I mean, they'll say that they're just verifying what they already have. For example, I'm just saying, like, if the last four digits of my social security number were 123, you know, four, and I just go, yes,
yeah,
one, two,
if
three,
you're doing
four
digits, JD, you have to go one, that? Two, three, four for four.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, okay.
And the scammers will say something like, yeah, that's correct. You got your last four correct, and do you know the first three in the middle two? And then you'll say the first three in the middle two, and they'll say, yep, that's what we have. You're correct. You know, and now read back your bank account to me just to make sure you have that right. And they'll tell you exactly, this is your number, that's your routing number, so we want this one. So you look there, read me the number. Okay, yep, you got it right. That's good. That's what we have. And, you know, they're just, they're con artists. So,
they're trying to make it feel like they're doing you a service, right?
Yeah, well, yeah. A couple things. They're trying to make you do that. They're doing a service to protect you. They might say that you were scammed or, you know, they might say that a relative's in trouble. That's what my friends were recently. They thought that they're, you know, they had one of their relatives was involved in a car accident. This is so common, too. And they're good at it. And they, you know, they basically told the people, they said, you know, you need bail money for your grandson or son or daughter or whatever. And they try to convince you to do that. So, you know, and they'll say stuff like, you know, it'll be for bond and we'll give you a receipt and blah, blah, blah. And it's just it's all a scam. No one will ever do that. So, you know, always call the person they're talking about, or if they're talking about your bank account or, you know, they're talking about something that might have been compromised, anything from credit card to an internet service, whatever. Call that service directly and handle it. It's unbelievable.
You've told me that before. Like if a credit card company calls up and says, hey, you're behind, we need you to pay. Say, okay, fine, I'll call you right back. And then take out your credit card, look at the back, and call that number and see what they say.
Yeah, because that'll work. I mean, I have a call into a scammer who left me a voicemail about a week ago saying that I'm in trouble with the IRS because I did not get my taxes in time and that I didn't fill out the paperwork for the extension. What a joke. You know, I mean, they'd never do that. So, of course, I called them back and they said they were busy. And so I got a voicemail. So I actually left them my number here. So maybe if they call during the show, we'll pick it up and we'll see what they have to say.
Of course you did. You love calling these guys.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, that'll be cool. We'll put it on speakerphone.
Leave that to the professionals, by the way, folks. Leave that to the professionals.
You know, on the best
from
thing,
a scammer,
like said,
just hang up, right?
Yeah,
just
exactly. Yeah, exactly. Don't call it back, hang up.
Okay.
And that's a really good point, Tim, that you make, too, is if you're on the no-call list, I mean, you know it's a scam right away because you're on the no-call list. You know, I mean, obviously right. For, you know, political advertisements, nonprofits, that's exempt or a company that you've approved. But, you know, if it's just somebody that's, you know, trying to sell you something or convince you that you need something, you know, it's just scammers.
It's just so, nonsense.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
Okay. So, one of the things that I've noticed is that you still see a lot of the utility scams. And one of the things that you always did with utility scams is saying, you know, your bill is due, go and get the gift card, or we're going to shut you down. And a lot of people are afraid of obviously losing your utilities. That's an important thing. But right now, in a lot of places in the United States, there has been a moratorium called, and they can't even turn off your power or natural gas or any of that stuff. Isn't that right?
Yeah, it is right. And that's the thing. And you have some experience in that too, Tim, is that we've talked about this off air, is that, a phone call isn't going to do it. I mean, if for any utility company, you're going to get every option possible to be able to make some sort of arrangement to work on that bill. Right now with what we're going through, it's not going to happen, period, because obviously a lot of people aren't working, a lot of stuff going on, and yes, and that's why, you know, everything from rent to utilities, et cetera, is kind of on hold right now.
Absolutely. And people are scared, though. And that's when scammers get excited, is when people are scared.
It is, because it's funny because everybody is trying and here and a couple of, and I'll tell you what, there's some really good websites out there. We have some on our website, the WCPPA. We had a link to the FBI, and they actually did a nice job and kind of went down the line with some of the virus scams. And what you just referred to, Tim, is a great point. Is people are on edge. They're looking. They're trying to look for the positive. I mean, I think in general, we're you know, the country, we're a bunch of fighters. We're trying to get through this, and these scammers they feed off that. And they try to get people to, you know, like everything from, you know, you can help by giving money to, you know, whatever virus. And I don't even want to give them credit for what they, you know, everything from causes to help people to cures to, you know, drugs that they say that you should buy from them, you know, that help you not get the virus, which is absolutely ridiculous, obviously.
Right.
But people are trying to, you know, they're when you're stressed out, sometimes you don't think as clear as you normally do. And I tell you what, though, too, it's important for especially, you know, the younger crew, middle-aged crew, is if you have older parents, check in with them, too, because they're getting bombarded with calls. They're getting antsy. And it's just that, you know, it's to say, hey, you know, let them know this stuff is going on, because a lot of times they don't know, you know, and it's good to let them know that, you know, it's just people aren't asking for that stuff, or, you know, have them call me, you know, or have them call or just hang up, you know, whatever you want to do.
Just hang up on these folks.
I saw the lady in, I think it was Pennsylvania, that she had one of our safety whistles we talked about, personal safety whistles, and she was doing a number on, she'd put them on speakerphone, she'd have like those, you know, like the headsets that we wear in the firing range, or guys wear to mow lawns and stuff. Yeah. She'd put those over her ears and she'd let that roll. I thought, hey, if you want to do that, that's fine too. But obviously, people are getting a little bored.
yeah. Well, I like to play things through my telephone. Like, where is that one? This is the one I like to play for them. The loser.
Price is right?
That's it exactly. Yep,
that's a good one. That's excellent.
Yeah, okay. Well, you lose. So
what I should start to do, Tim?
Go ahead. I'm sorry.
Oh, no, what I should start to do actually is I should just try to, like, you know, go on like video with them, and I could.
Uh-oh, we gotta get this. There we go. Full size. There he is. Holy cow.
Let's get him going here. Lights out. There we go. Lights
on. He's winking at us.
There we go. We got him, Timmy.
Oh, my God.
I should just tell him that I'm in pursuit of them. And this guy can float. He can go overseas and everything to get them.
Your next-door neighbor must think you are a crime scene right about now. Oh, my goodness. Holy cow. It's quieter than earlier. Earlier you had the thing on. Oh, he got droopy-eyed again.
He did. I shut him down here, too. So, yeah, he's going to sleep.
He's sleepy. But he was louder earlier.
Yeah, I think the battery's
already going on.
Yeah, we did. I'm not going to turn the siren on because the family's eating in the other room. And
just put one over your head. There you go.
Yeah, exactly. There's a siren. So, anyways, he's a good background for our show, so I like it. I'm actually blocked him out here, but we'll give him some.
Yeah, time. Give him some equal time.
Got to fix his eyes though.
That's he's looking wrong. Oh, thank you. I was worried about him. Yeah. Now he looks happier, too. He seems
kind of looks like one of the cars in the movie Cars, doesn't he?
Yeah, he sure does. And I just came back from California and saw Cars Land at California Adventure, which was really neat. But I literally got out of there just before things started shutting down all over the country, and I feel very fortunate and blessed to have been able to do that.
I actually saw that, and I was thinking about you because I had a relative in Italy. and it was getting close. I mean, when you're starting to get into the you know, the 30 hours and third 28 hours and stuff, it's like, man, because you I don't think this came on so quickly, Tim, you know, where we went from kind of like, you know, okay, you know, what are we going to do here? We're going to have to distance a little bit to basically shut down Central.
Yeah.
It happened. How long did you make it? What was it, like a couple days or?
Well, what happened for me for California.
Okay.
I got out of California the week before the shutdowns.
Okay.
2 weeks, actually. Because the next weekend I was in Pittsburgh for a convention, a horror movie convention. I know you tell me those are too scary, but I did go. And I came back. And literally, I worked 1 week at work, and they told me, you can decide if you're going to work from home or if you want to come in. And they asked me that on Friday, and on Friday, I was like, I'll come in. There will be lots of parking spaces. This will be wonderful. I came in on Monday, and literally, our big boss came by and said, you know what? We don't even want you here Tuesday. I want you working out of the house. I was like, really? He said, you know, you're here now, fine, but grab all your stuff that you're going to need and work out of the house. So that's how quick everything changed. It was like bang, 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 bang. We were being told social distance that Monday when we were in, but they were making sure we were like 3 cubes apart and all that sort of stuff. I'll tell you that put the fear of God into me when that started, because I had heard about it and I'm like, they're not serious. This is not going to go. And it was like, nope, shut her down. And you know, I work for what would be considered an essential service here in the US. And, but I do have the capability to work from home. So I've been doing that now for 3 weeks.
And nice. There you go.
I like this part. I like the not shaving
everywhere. So do I. Yeah. That'll, as soon as it's over, that'll go. But it's kind of funny. You can always experiment with your.
When not too many people are going to watch you, then I ruin it by doing live shows. Yeah, like, well, now people are going to see this mess. Oh, well. So,
I hear you.
Hey, you mentioned our good friends over at the Wisconsin Crime Prevention Practitioners Association a moment ago. And really, they got something coming up that we probably want to discuss a little bit.
We have a lot of audience, civilian is what they call them. But I mean, this is kind of interesting. Because we have like law enforcement, security specialists, educators, anybody interested in crime prevention for the state. It's actually come, we have people from Minnesota, we've had them from Iowa, we've had them from Illinois, where else? Michigan. I mean, so it's kind of a Midwest thing, you know. And with training, as you know, in law enforcement, well, maybe we did. I mean, law enforcement's strapped, I mean, right now. I mean, they're, you know, I mean, talk about front lines. I mean, I get the medical people are front lines, but and doing a great job. But I got to get a shout out to the men and women in blue, because, I mean, at least in the hospital, people are, they're happier helping them and stuff. I mean, some of the people that the law enforcement has to deal with obviously aren't nice people. They're called felons. And, criminals. They're the kind of people that need to be in jail. Yeah. And they don't care about anybody other than themselves. Right. And a lot of times they're putting a lot of people at risk. So I give them a lot of credit right now, because it's not fun as this goes, you know. And, you know, I mean, they're getting, you know, a lot of protection and stuff. But at the same time, you know, it's just the people they're dealing with don't want to be dealt with sometimes, and that can make it really difficult. So with that said, there's not a lot of training opportunities right now for them because, you know, I mean, they're, you know, there's no technical no one's holding classes other than maybe webinars like what we're doing. And a lot of times that's not as, I guess, beneficial for law enforcement. They need a lot of more face-to-face interaction. Well, with that said, hopefully by October 28th through the 30th, that'll be okay to do. And yeah, we've got a really nice one in beautiful Oshkosh, Wisconsin. This premier Best Western hotel is just
Stayed there. It's beautiful.
Yeah, it's right on the water. It's beautiful.
Right on the lake. It's downtown Oshkosh. I think within walking distance of the Museum for World War II.
Yeah, it is. You're correct. And cigar bars, regular taverns, great restaurants. You can literally park your car there on the 27th
of 20. Okay, did everybody notice I knew about the cultural thing that was in the area? And JD knew where every gin joint.
I know. I'm terrible.
That figured out.
I've enjoyed Oshkosh many times. And then I played baseball there. You know, I love Oshkosh. That's a good
Wait. He was going down a road and then he turned away.
Yeah.
Everybody noticed that. Okay.
Yeah. Well, and I'll tell the audience this too right now is we kind of had a lapse here. And even though I'm an older guy, I still play baseball competitively. I ruptured my Achilles tendon in June. Worst injury I've ever had.
Hold on just a second. Somebody just joined us on video that is a Dallas Cowboys fan. And I think we just need to...
Tony Romo?
No, it isn't Tony Romo. This is an actual Texan. Just joined us, so...
Okay.
We got to watch our words when we're talking about sports because she obviously knows nothing about them. Okay, go on.
Oh, man. You are vicious. Now, if that was a Vikings fan, I'd have no issues with that comment.
No, she's a very good friend. Yeah.
There you go. Oh, that's good. So that's why I've been rehabbing heavy, and it's a long process. So
you're rehabbing, not able to get out much, and then it's like, okay, now you get to stay indoors all the time.
Yeah. Somebody kiddingly said you should have ruptured it a month ago. And I'm like, yeah, I should have.
Yeah.
Because I missed the whole summer. Yeah. And fall for that matter. But yeah. Whatever. I was walking without any help for a father-daughter event when one of my daughters goes to Madison. My goal was in October to be at that event without anything. And I made it, which was good. So yeah.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
That's great. We are not getting a whole lot of activity in that chat room, and I probably scared away poor Vanessa there.
Yeah, you probably did. Nice job, Tim.
That's what I do. It's all part of what I do. But I think what we were talking about prior to the show is that we wanted to start doing the show a little bit more often, and from the Skype, it makes it a lot easier because you live on the opposite side of town from me. And
that's an understatement. Yeah, I can get, talk about Oshkosh. I can get to Oshkosh sooner than I get to your house from my house.
Absolutely.
There you go. So, and I'm serious, actually. Yeah.
One of the things we want to know from all of you is, do you prefer us on YouTube or you prefer us on Facebook? We can do either. We're very, very talented gentlemen here, but we do want to hear from you, and we do want that when we're on live next that you join us, and we will make that announcement out on our regular website, which is policeonthescene.com. I think I got it on this one. There you go. policeonthescene.com. Or, of course, you can go to our Facebook page at any time, and it'll be right there telling when we next plan to do a program, and we'll see what JD's hat will be for that show. Oh, wait, he's doing something.
This is the I had a guy in one of my police, or I should say emergency services media classes.
Okay.
So not really crime prevention, but I teach media too because of my history in TV, and he was from the fire department.
I don't know if everybody knows this that's watching, but you're kind of a big deal.
Yeah, Ron Burgundy, yeah, right. There we go. I don't know how to put this, but I'm kind of a big deal. People know me. I'm very important. I have many leather-bound books, and my apartment smells of rich mahogany. Merlin Olsen comes over on occasion. This is stupid. No. Yeah. So, anyways, and this is the embarrassing part. This guy was a great guy. He's a firefighter, and obviously, his fire department starts with a J.
Oh no! Oh no!
And, I'm trying to think what the name of it is. It'll come to me. But it's a really nice hat. So yeah, there we go. I believe it's okay. Jackson, but I'm not 100% sure. Okay. So anyways, yeah.
Note to everybody that sends hats to JD, what you're going to want to do is write the actual name of the place inside the hat so exactly. that he can look yeah. at it and know which one he's grabbing.
Yes, thank you, Tim. Very good advice to the audience. You know what?
I have a hat over here. Should I wear the hat I have? Hold on.
Okay, let's see it.
Run the show while I'm...
Okay, I will. And while Tim's getting his hat, folks, the other thing, too, I want to mention is with some of the phone scams that we've been... the uptick in them since everybody's kind of, home a lot more is that... you're getting a lot of different calls from, and even if you think they're related to things that you have, from car insurance to auto insurance to anything like that, the things that everybody normally does have. Again, no personal information. I actually had a number. You can block them and show your relatives if you can. Obviously, you can block calls. And I was actually looking for one of my voicemail scams that the guy left, and there was a number that I had blocked, and they left 72 voicemails in 66 days, but they were blocked, so I didn't get them. Wow. But when you look, you can look on your phone and find the ones that you had blocked, and it was like, yeah, no legitimate business would do that, and if they were legit, I'd never do business with them. Anybody that I'd call that
happy
much,
and
so.
Mad higher pressure. Okay, now here
yeah,
we go.
Yeah, exactly.
Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay. There you go. You know which one it is? I'm kidding.
Is that GPD? There you go. Hey, that's pretty close to this one, man. I mean, the fonts are close. Yeah. Wow. Look at that. The D is identical.
You should probably tell everybody what the GPD stands for.
That's Glendale Police Department, the one in Wisconsin, not California or Arizona.
Okay.
Yeah.
I have another hat. This one, we'll call this. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
You know that, was it last year? 2 year? Yes, last year I went to the Panama Canal, right?
Okay, I did not know.
And
that, but
I went to the Panama Canal in a cruise, and it was beautiful. It was wonderful. Before I left, I thought, you know what I would like to have on my Panama cruise?
What?
Panama hat.
Oh, okay.
So I went on Amazon.
Oh, no.
This is what I got.
Okay. Look at you.
Okay. But it was $3.
Okay.
It was made of paper, though.
Less than a cup of coffee at Starbucks.
Yeah,
so
it
went. Yeah, there you go.
So was my first car.
Yeah, very good point.
It's made of some sort of paper substance. When I was in Panama, I did get a real Panama hat. I'll bring it in one of these shows. We'll always have hat time, I think.
Okay, yeah, because that's funny. We, you know, a little quiet in the chat room, but it's people are so cool about, because they know I'll wear them, man. They're like, if you send them, I'll wear them. So I get that, you know, quite a bit.
But anyway, the Panama hats are beautiful. They're only about $30 to get them down there. But you can actually roll them up like a newspaper, and they'll come back to their shape. And they're super cool on a hot day, and you're wearing them. I made a mistake. I think I got one size smaller than I should have, but I'm always super scared of hats blowing off my head because I've had this happen on two occasions, and they were my two favorite hats of all time. So I'm like nuts on the subject.
Okay.
But I did get a Panama hat, and it looks ultra cool. But I do keep this one around as my scam hat.
Yeah, that's nice. That looks like a Lego hat.
Something
come that a on. Lego would wear.
Well, we're doing personal appearances. We should bring this bad boy around.
Yep.
People, yeah, that's Lego. Like, that is the most beautiful thing. Yeah.
There you go.
It's
there you
literally,
go.
I've put it on my head twice. It's fallen apart. Yeah. It's awesome.
Yeah, that's good.
Much higher
that's
quality.
I
didn't show people
the
back.
Airport.
Hold on. We got to show people the back. Well, wait. I have the control here.
I don't have the hat right now, but I do have the mouse pad.
Look at that. Check.
Very nice. Very nice.
You know what? Actually, let's try this, JD. Are you ready?
There's the mouse pad. There you go.
That's nice.
Yeah,
okay. Here's what we're going to do, JD. Take off the hat. Take off the hat.
This one?
Yes. Take it off.
Oh, not within my hair today, dude. Okay. Yeah, it's not looking
turn
good.
Your head. I
want to do that.
I want
to
see
office.
If the name of the fire department's on the back of your hat. And you
it's
don't even
not. Know. I checked.
You checked? Okay.
Yes. I checked. It's not back there.
Okay.
Because there you go.
I know how my mom and dad are when he's lost his glasses.
Yeah, and not. I had like my little PT workout in my our makeshift weight. Well, now everybody's working out at home, so yeah, I don't wanna. Yeah, I'd look a little like I'm trying to think. My hair would look like trying to get somebody that would look like Spicoli maybe on Fast Times. It's not looking good. So we won't do that. We won't do that to whoever's still out there. So. Yeah,
well,
we're getting
we went
close.
Overtime. We went overtime, buddy.
We did. You know, and the one thing too is we got some dumb. If we continue doing this, everybody, we've got some video come out. We got some police video from some dumb criminals, which is hilarious. And I guess when you're running from the police, don't get tased. I mean, because you're going to get tased if you jump on their hood of their car to try to escape. It's usually not the way to do it. So we got that coming up maybe on our next show. And then I know I'm going to get one of these scammers. Now they're calling quite often, and I'm going to start to, we'll get some intel on them. So we'll go with that too. So I think I'm a visual and an audio learner. So when I hear this stuff, it really helps, and hopefully that'll help our audience.
Fantastic.
Hey, there's a stupid criminal story right there. Do we have one?
No, I'm just showing off the graphic.
Okay, good. Yeah, we'll have one next time.
So people will know to tune in.
Yeah, we got this one in. This video came in a little late, so I'll give it to you, Tim. And
well, we're impressed that you were able to use the Skype. I was telling people there is not a chance we get on time today. And it worked great. You're doing much better than a lot of my beauty contestants for my other show.
Well, you know, I tell you what, with training and stuff, especially with the law enforcement, some of the crime prevention classes, I mean, the tech school, I've been able to work part, you know, Jason Weber, our vice president and stuff is with Northwest Technical College out of Green Bay. And you better learn, because right now that's how business is going. So,
well,
yeah.
I'll tell you, this is something that when you're doing these interviews and you're going to be broadcast and they tell you, I need you to be in landscape mode. What they mean is, let's say this is a telephone, okay? That means you turn it like this, okay? And it's landscape. It's the way everything looks on your television for the last 80 years. And this is what most of my interviews like to do.
Oh.
And then you're like, okay, take a look at what we have on the screen right now. If you turn that the opposite direction, you just ruined this shot, right? You ruined this picture. You've ruined the other segment we had over here. That would be totally ruined. Where am I going to put you? I don't know.
No.
and this happens, I would say, somewhere in the 85 to 90% percentile. The other thing I tell them very often, and I've just given up on this, because, well, when I started, you almost needed this. Today, it isn't as big of a deal, but I'm always like, call from a landline. Let me get as good of a connection as I possibly can. And then, of course, they're like, oh, I have to leave the food court. And I'm like, yeah, because that's a landline. No, you're on your phone. Stop it. Don't do this again. You know, and it was constant. And back then, it wasn't even video, and it would get splotchy doing it. Now, today, the quality of the connections is much better. But
I was only laughing because, you know, I do some of the media training with Joel LaBarbera with LaBarbera Media Group, and you sounded identical with the landscaping. It's so true. And he teaches college down at a couple universities in Florida, and everything you said there, he would just go off on the landscaping. It's like, man, you want video, you want it to be good. Landscape, you gotta get it.
The only place that's appropriate is Instagram stories, Facebook stories, and if you have the $5,000 movie poster displays that they now have at the movie theaters that show the posters, that if you happen to have one of those, you go ahead right there, girlfriend. Then you go ahead and do that. Otherwise, don't do it. I'll tell you the other thing. If you're using Instagram, now I'm going to go off on this, but, you know, we're already over. But here's the other thing. If you're using any of the programs like Buffer or Hootsuite or anything where you're distributing pictures, okay, on Facebook, Twitter, all those things, a lot of them, if you do turn it in what's called portfolio mode, it won't turn it back. And what'll happen is you'll send out a photo that's sideways.
Yep.
And it looks like you're not a very intelligent person. Just don't do it. Don't do it. Take it off. Oh, okay. All right.
Now, the other thing, Timmy, really cool, and I mean, this is completely off subject.
Yeah, we ran off the rails.
If you ever have to give a phone interview, you know, with anybody, especially now in any, whatever you might do, I just did one with some of the media. Unfortunately, we had an active shooter here in Milwaukee, and they needed some expertise to talk about that. And I always go off the hard line in my home. It's so much. They love it too, Tim, for all the reasons you just said. It's so much better.
Well, your picture, you know, despite it being you, has been pretty good. Right now, as I say this, of course, the internet is playing a game with us, but it's going to catch up again in a second. And we have gotten really good video from you for, I would say, about 80% of the night. And let's keep in mind, right now is probably the busiest the internet has been in the history of the internet, with everybody downloading their Netflix shows. And in Europe, they actually slowed down the speed of thing. It just won't speed back up now that I said how good the picture was, and it started going blocky the moment I said it. That's pretty typical.
No, and you're exactly right. We've even seen that here a little bit. It's right now in 845. You know, it's bad at once. And I took a ride last night, and it's still a little eerie. I took a ride last night at about 8:30, and it was like, it's just, it reminds me, I guess, like, the only thing I could think of is it reminded me of, like, Christmas Day night. You know, I mean, at every night, at like, you know, there's not many people out and about, you know. That was about the only analogy I can think of.
The funny part is, while you were talking there, it started really jittering bad during that. I think that's the internet saying it's time for us to close our show.
Yeah, I agree with that. Gene. All right, well, I'll give it a thanks, everybody, for joining us. I see a couple popped in there at the end. We'll have something in the future, and I'll use the old line. I said, with that, I'll be 10-8, my friends.